Let's talk about women who get hair loss that is related to various hormonal changes. Let's first start with the menstrual cycle. At day 15, when you're ovulating, you get this huge spike of estrogen, okay? And then in the next 2 weeks, you're going to get a spike in progesterone and androgen. So, depending on what time of the month you're getting hair loss, will give us clues as to what hormone is involved. But most women tend to lose hair in the second half of the menstrual cycle when there's a spike of androgens. Now, when a woman goes through menopause, they can continue to have hair loss to some degree because there's this faint hormonal rhythm going on to some degree. So if you're getting hair loss pre-menopause, so let's say, for example, you're in your 20s, 30s, or the first part of your 40s, right? And you're getting hair loss at the second half of your cycle, you need to lower androgens. The best way to do that is to lower your insulin, okay? That means you need to lower your carbohydrates. That is the single most important thing to help stop hair loss. So you want to go on a low carb diet, that's keto, as well as doing intermittent fasting. But let's say, for example, you're postmenopausal and your hair is falling out. That is a situation where you're very low in progesterone, you're pretty low in androgens, but you're also low in estrogen as well. So you have a lessening of all three hormones, in which case you need to take something called DHEA. That's a precursor to those hormones, and it'll help you elevate the hormones. But here's a catch-22. If you take a very small amount, let's say 10 milligrams, you'll increase more estrogen. If you start taking more, let's say 20, 30, even 40 milligrams, you're going to also spike androgens too much, and that may cause more hair loss. So, with taking DHEA for hair loss, you want to just take a very small amount to increase estrogen and the other hormones just by a little bit, because too much is not a good idea. Okay, so let's say someone's postpartum, they just had a baby, and they have this severe drop in estrogen. Well, that can cause just patches of hair coming out of your head, in which case you need to take 10 milligrams of DHEA, and that'll bring it up nicely. Let's say you have PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome. That's a situation where your androgens are too high. Simply reduce your insulin by going on keto and intermittent fasting. Another really good thing to take to help your pituitary and ovary communication is to take inositol, okay? Inositol. They're actually sweet vitamins. There's no sugar in it, but inositol will help PCOS big time. Okay, let's say, for example, your period is very heavy, okay, and you're losing blood. That is high levels of estrogen. In this case, you do not want to take DHEA. You want to take DIM. Now, DIM actually does the opposite. It lowers estrogen. It's a concentrated cruciferous product, and it's very, very good for people that are estrogen dominant. The other thing you want to take is iron, and I would highly recommend getting that from animal products like red meat, liver. You can take liver pills. That's the best source of iron. All right, next scenario. Let's say, for example, you have a slow thyroid because your estrogen increased. Now, how are you going to know that it's high estrogen? Well, it could be you just gave birth, okay? That high spike of estrogen will definitely shut the thyroid down. And so, if you have a hypothyroid condition right after birth or during birth, then we know it's an estrogen problem. Or let's say you started taking birth control pills and then you ended up with a hypothyroid condition. Or let's say, for example, you took hormone replacement therapy and you ended up with a slow thyroid. Or if you have heavy periods, which is high estrogen, and you have a slow thyroid, then you have clues to know what caused that. So, what do we do with high estrogen? We take DIM. What does DIM do? It lowers estrogen. It's a product that you can get online. Bile salts greatly help the conversion of T4 to T3 through your liver. So, taking bile salts improve a slow thyroid. And then selenium is very, very important because most hypothyroid cases are Hashimoto's, and that's more of a situation where selenium can help you. One last scenario. Let's say you're taking birth control pills for a period of time and you stop taking birth control pills and all of a sudden your hair starts falling out. That is an estrogen crash, okay? The way to bring that up is simply by taking inositol because inositol resets the flow of hormones between your pituitary and your ovary. And lastly, we don't want to forget about two additional things that can cause your hair loss. One is a trace mineral deficiency and a B vitamin deficiency. So trace minerals and B vitamins, including biotin, can greatly support hair and prevent it from falling out. All right, those are the different scenarios that could potentially affect your hair.
Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.